हेलो हेलो, चेक चेक, वॉइस इज क्लियर। गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग टू एवरीवन, गुड मॉर्निंग इंडिया, वेलकम टू गेट अकाडमी 2.0। सो आई एम सतीश कुमार, फैकल्टी ऑफ मेजरमेंट्स एंड इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशन फ्रॉम गेट अकाडमी। लव यू ऑल, आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर प्रेजेंट हियर। यस्टरडेज क्लास वॉज एक्सलेंट, so much of fabulous response came from all the students, and today we are here with a new topic. Hi Mathurji, good morning. Tanjim Kanam, good morning. Sneha Savant, good morning. Akshat Jain, good morning. Every student, good morning. Dear students, please try to share this link as early as possible to your classmates, your group mates, your WhatsApp mates, your Telegram mates, all the people, so that these ESC sessions must be This ESC sessions must be successful. This ESC sessions must be very much successful, my dear students. Why? Because we are discussing the qualitative conceptual questions. We are discussing the qualitative conceptual questions, my dear students. Okay. Yesterday we have discussed one beautiful question. How many of you are present yesterday? How many of you attended yesterday's class? Yesterday we have discussed the temperature effect. Temperature effect on the meters. Such a beautiful concept it is. Actually, the temperature concept is very less covered in other classes, but here I have given a beautiful explanation. Why? Because that gives the clarity about the meter's effect on the temperature. That gives the clarity about the meter's effect on the temperature. Hemant Kumar, love you all. Tanjim Kanam, good, good, good. Chalo. Deepams, Arindya Bose, instrumentation, Sneha Savant, good morning. Chalo, dear students. So here I want to talk to you. One important concept today, we were going to the moving iron. In PMMC sometimes some questions are coming on deflection sensitivity. Why? Because the sensitivity problems are most important. So deflection sensitivity, so how to understand this deflection sensitivity? So deflection sensitivity generally is given as degree per micro ampere, degree per ampere, or radians per ampere also, radians per ampere also, radians per ampere also. So you have to understand how it works, degree per ampere or radians per ampere. So this is one more important point, deflection sensitivity. So very, very important conceptual understanding is required for deflection sensitivity. For example, if you take, my dear students, in PMMC, we know very well. So this is a rough diagram of PMMC. We are giving the current and we are getting the deflection. So we know the basic formula, deflection torque is equal to controlling torque. Deflection torque formula is Bina and controlling torque formula is equal to K theta. So we are getting, actually, according to the current, we are getting the deflection, yes or not? So if you see the theta, if you see the theta Bina, that is B by K into INA, if you take this also constant, so theta is proportional to current. Theta is proportional to current. So if you take the sensitivity theta by I, so that will be BNA by K. BNA by K. Okay, na? So this is what we call sensitivity, deflection sensitivity. What we call this as? BNA by K. So this is what we call deflection sensitivity. This is what we call as deflection sensitivity. All of you, please make a note of this point. Deflection sensitivity. Units are degree per ampere. Degree per ampere. Please make a note of these points. Hi Anita Gandham, please make a note of these points. Sometimes questions are asked. This type of questions are asked in the bridges. In the bridges, these type of questions can be asked. In the bridges, these type of questions can be asked, my dear students. Please try to write down. All of you, please note it down. I will go for a beautiful question on the bridges. this understanding is important. Everything depends upon the temperature. Why? Because theta depends upon N. Theta depends upon N. N is made by copper. Theta depends upon N. Theta depends upon N. N is a number of turns. Number of turns definitely is going to be affected because of the temperature. The temperature can affect the coil's dimensions. Temperature can affect the sensitivities. Sensitivity in instrumentation, then is the, there is one word called drifting sensitivity. Sensitivity also can be drifted. Sensitivity also can be drifted, my dear students. Why? Because that affects the temperature. That because of the temperature, the N can be affected, Mathur. N is a number of turns. Number of turns means it related to copper. Slight deflection will be there in this. Theta is proportional to N. And N is made by copper. N is a number of turns. Okay? Chalo. Now, dear students, listen. Is there any limit of temperature for beams to have good sensitivity? Yes, there are certain ratings are there, yaar. There are certain ratings. We are not going for that, all the ratings. Okay. When you purchase the PMMC, definitely there are some ratings will be given. When you purchase the PMMC, on the PMMC instrument itself, there are certain ratings will be given. What is the current range? What is the voltage range? What is the magnetic field range? What is the temperature range? Everything will be given on the instrument. Everything will be given on the instrument. There is no need to remember all those values. Not much importance. These are the just data. Okay, chal. Now, if you see this question, sometimes the questions are asked in the bridges with the help of this deflection sensitivity. So, this is R, this is R, this is R, this is R, and here is our supply voltage. Suppose the supply voltage is 25 volts and this resistors initially as 100 ohms. Initially all the resistors are 100 ohms. And case 1, I am taking a meter. This is the PMMC. And the internal resistance of the meter is infinite. Internal resistance of the meter is given as infinite. Okay. Now, if one of the resistance varies due to temperature. So, these R are made by metals. Okay, na? So, if the del R in the first resistance is suppose 10 ohms. Okay. So, calculate the bridge sensitivity. Bridge sensitivity. Dear students, try to understand. Calculate the bridge sensitivity. Units are given as millivolts per ohm. Try to do it fast. Do you understand the question? Measurement subject real time power system mein kaisa use hoga? My dear student, whatever may be your other subjects, please ask some subject related questions. Okay, don't waste the time. You know very well, wherever you go, meters are compulsory. Measurements ka application is only meters. Measurements ka kuch bhi application nahi hai. Measurements ka application is meters. How to use the meters in the real time? You should be having a knowledge of which meter has to be chosen when you are working for a power plant instrumentation company. My dear students, listen carefully. When you are working for a power plant, you should know which meter has to be used whenever there is a DC measurement, current measurement, voltage measurement, flux measurement, power factor measurement, inductance measurements, capacitance measurement, which meter has to be used, where DC bridges like Wheatstone bridge should be used, where AC bridges should be used. These all information you should have. Then only you can do. Otherwise, you cannot do. Okay, na? Do you understand, my dear student? Tanjim, in the power system analysis, whenever you want to find the component values, there you can use these meters, frequency measurements. So, how to do this question? He has given a simple question, but there is a case one. I have taken the meter resistance as infinite. So, when the meter resistance is infinite, so if you check the current passing can be divided like this. So, if you take this as node A, this as node B, this as node C, this as node D. Now, what happens? As a meter resistance is infinite, no current passes here. So, these two currents are in series. These two resistors are in series. And here also, these two, sorry, I made a mistake. So, these two resistors are in series. Am I right or not? So, if you apply some quarter bridge formula, V bridge is equal to this particular potential difference minus this particular potential difference. VAB minus VAD. Why? Because no current passes, I can apply the voltage division rule. So, VAB means this resistance is changed to R plus delta R. One of the resistance is increased by how much? Delta R. He has not mentioned the sign. When he has not mentioned the sign, you can take plus by default. Okay, now sometimes in the question, he will take plus or minus. But whenever he is not mentioned the question sign, you can take it as this. So, VAB minus VAD. What is VAB? The resistance is changing. So, that is R plus delta R divided by R plus delta R plus R, because these two resistors are in series, into supply voltage minus R by R plus R. So, when you take these two simplifications, and if you simplify this, how much you are going to get, my dear student? So, this is R plus delta R. This is 2R plus delta R minus 1 by 2. So, if you simplify, you are going to get 4R plus 2 delta R, and this is 2R plus 2 delta R minus 2R minus delta R. So, 2 delta R delta R 4R. So, this is approximately, accurately, V bridge is equal to Vs into delta R by 4R plus 2 delta R. Approximately, we can write V bridge is equal to Vs into delta R by 4R. This is the formula for V bridge. So, here if you observe, the V bridge is purely proportional to delta R. So, the changeable input quantity is this, changeable output quantity is this. Question asked is bridge sensitivity. So, bridge sensitivity means here V bridge per delta R. So, that is approximately Vs by 4 into R. So, that is 25 by 4 into 100. So, you are going to get how much? My dear students, how much you are going to get? Can you answer this? 62.5. Oh my God. 62.5 millivolts. Okay. You are telling in units. Units. 6.25 into 10 power minus 2 volts per ohms. Suppose the question asked in volts per ohm only, millivolts per ohm he asked. So, millivolts per ohm he asked, 62.5 millivolts per ohm. Very good. 62.5 millivolts per ohm. So, this is what we call sensitivity of bridge. All of you comfortable now? It is a quarter bridge. Yes, Ananja Bose, if you are instrumentation student, you know it as a quarter bridge. If you are instrumentation student, you know it's a quarter bridge. For electrical students and EC students, they don't know what is quarter bridge. So, that's why they can derive like this. All of you comfortable? 62.5 millivolts per ohm. Clear? But this formula, remember my dear students, this particular formula, whatever we have derived, is valid if and only if the conditions are meter resistance must be infinite. Second condition is, Second condition is all its initial resistors must be equal. All initial resistors must be equal. Do you understand? Do you understand? Then only you can do these such type of problems. All of you agree or not? All of you agree? My dear students. Very good. Mathur, 62.5 millivolts. This formula is valid. Aranjabose, are you right? What I'm asking? Vs by 4 into del R by R, meter resistance must be infinite, all the resistance must be equal. Then only you can apply this formula. Agree or not? Yeah. Suppose the same question, shall we go for the next question? Suppose case 2, sometimes he will club the concept of network theory. Case 2. Suppose the same question can be asked like this. So this is 100 ohms and this is the variable. This is 100 ohms. This is also 100 ohms. This is also 100 ohms. This is 25 volts. So this time he has kept a meter. Okay, na? The meter resistance is 1 kilo ohm. The galvanometer internal resistance. What is meter? This is a PMMC. PMMC internal resistance is 1 kilo ohm. And sensitivity of the meter, sensitivity, deflection sensitivity of the meter. Okay, na? I'm using the word deflection sensitivity. I'm using the word deflection sensitivity. Deflection sensitivity, I am giving 0.1 microampere. Do you understand? 0.1 microampere. Sorry. 0.1 degree. 0.1 degree per microampere or milliampere. 0.1 degree per milliampere. Okay, na? The deflection sensitivity of this meter is how much? Deflection sensitivity of PMMC is given as how much? 0.1 degree per milliampere. Now, for a del R of 10 ohms, what is the deflection? Deflection in meter is dash degree. Can you do it? Please try to do it. Case 2, this type of question also expected. Sir, if change in resistance due to temperature is plus 10, then how to proceed? That only we have done now. Change in resistance due to temperature plus 10 only we have done now, Mathur. We have done that only. For 10 ohms only we have done the previous problem. Yeah. Try to answer this question. So, this particular del R is 10 ohms. So, this del R is 10 ohms. And the PMMC internal resistance is 1 kilo ohm. Deflection sensitivity of the PMMC is given as 0.1 degree per milliampere. For a del R of 10 ohms, deflection in PMMC is dash degrees. How to do this question? Try to think. Tech Mathur Chase plus 10. Plus R. I got it, sir. Then it will be negative. Mathurji, it will be, if you are using del R, you will take the V bridge magnitude. Okay, na? You will take the V bridge magnitude. Anyway, your PMMC gives the average value, Mathur. Chalo, how to do this question? All of you understanding the questions, my dear students? All of you are following the question, what I am telling? So, here a circuit was given like this. And these all the resistors are 100, 100, 100. All the resistors are given 100, 100, 100. and deflection sensitivity is given. So how to solve this question? Can I apply the formula V bridge is equal to Vs by 4 into delta R bar? Anandja Bose, can I apply this formula now? Tanjim, Sneha, can I apply this formula? V bridge is equal to Vs by 4 into del R by R. Can I apply? No, I cannot apply. Why? Because the meter resistance is not infinite. The meter resistance is finite. Then you have to go for some network theory concept. Question asked here is the current deflection. So if you are expecting the deflection in this meter, so what is the question asked, dear student? If you see here, is asking the deflection and the current is passing here. So first of all, you have to find out the current passing through the meter, then only you will get the degrees of deflection here. Am I right? Degrees of deflection here. So theta is proportional to current passing through the meter. So if you want to know the degree and you have to know the current passing through the meter. So what is the current passing through the meter? So what we have to do, Pranali? Very good, Pranali. To find out the current passing through the meter, the current passing through the galvanometer or current passing through the PMMC, whatever you say, the current passing through the meter, if you want to find out, first the circuit has to be converted into Thevenin's equivalent model. To find out the V Thevenin's, so what I have to do now? This entire circuit, first V Thevenin's you have to find out. So how to find out the V Thevenin's? V Thevenin's means voltage across these two terminals. So how to find out that? So if you check this as the resistor and this as another resistor and this as the another resistor. So now the modified resistors, this is 100, this is 100, this is 100, but this is 110 ohms. This is 110 ohms. So this can be taken as 25 volts. So first of all, I want to find out the V Thevenin's. So I will open the meter. So when I open the meter, now the voltage across this can be taken as V Thevenin's now, my dear students. Yes or no? Anindya Bose, are you there? Yes. We can apply the V Thevenin's. V Thevenin's is the best thing. Okay, with the shortest method. So V Thevenin's is nothing but V quarter bridge voltage or not? How many of you agree? V Thevenin's is nothing but V quarter bridge or not? This is 110 means this is 100 plus 10 na. This is 110 means this is 100 plus 10 na. So all the resistors are equal. Now V Thevenin's is V quarter bridge. That is Vs by 4 into del R by R na. Anindya Bose, are you agreeing? Anindya Bose, yes, very good. V Thevenin's is nothing but quarter bridge. So directly we can apply previous formula, that is 25 by 4. Del R is how much, beta? Del R is equal to 10. R is equal to 100. I think we have done just before. 25 by 40. Okay. So 4, 6, ja, 25. 4, 6, ja, 24. 1, 6.25. Okay, na? So I think 0.625 volts. Am I right? 0.625. Correct, na? Any mistake we have done? Is it right? 0.595. How 0.599? Anindya Bose, how it is 0.595? Any mistake we have done? 25 by 4. Calc check up. 0.625, correct only na? Anindya Bose, it is 0.625 or 0.5? 0.625, yeah, don't confuse me here. So 25 by 4. That is 0.625 volts. 0.625 volts. This is the V Thevenin's. Then we have to go for R Thevenin's. How to find out the R Thevenin's? So to find out the R Thevenin's, what I have to do now? To find out the R Thevenin's, I have to short this voltage source. I have to short this voltage source. So how to find out this R Thevenin's? To find out the R Thevenin's, so when you short this and you have to find the R Thevenin's in between these two resistors. Okay, so please tell me, what is the R Thevenin's? So this is 110, this is 100, this is 100, this is 100. Am I right? So what is the R Thevenin's? How much is the R Thevenin's? Make it fast. Tanjeem Kanam, are you there? Sneha, are you there? So these two are parallel. When you take this particular open and if you check it, so 110 is parallel with 100 plus 100 parallel with 100. Am I right or not? Am I right or not? So how much you are going to get? So 110 into 100 by 110 plus 100 plus this is 100 into 100 by 100 plus 100. Am I right? So if you check now, 110 into 100, how much it is going to be? 110 into 100 divided by 210. So this is coming as 52.38 and this is 1 by 2, I think, 0.5. Am I right? 100, 100 parallel. So plus 0.5. Sorry. This is 50. This is 50, right? So I'm getting it as 102.38 ohms. All of you agree R Thevenin's? R Thevenin's I'm getting as 102.38. Sneha, correct, correct. So 102.38. So I got V Thevenin's. I got V Thevenin's. I got R Thevenin's. Now come back to the circuit. So this entire circuit now can be converted into simple form. Why? Because voltage across this PMMC and equivalent resistance of this particular circuit you have done. So now if you draw the circuit, so this is the V Thevenin's, this is the R Thevenin's, and this is our PMMC. This PMMC is having some internal resistance. So this is the meter resistance, and now you can find out the meter current or not from the circuit. Do you understand, my dear students? Do you understand Thevenin's circuit for PMMC? Agree? So what is the meter current? I can write directly V Thevenin's by R Thevenin's plus R meter. V Thevenin's by R Thevenin's plus R meter. So V Thevenin's, how much you got? 0.625. This you got as 0.625. And what is the R Thevenin's? 102.38. What is the meter resistance? Meter resistance is 1 kilo ohm. Meter resistance is 1 kilo ohm. That is 1000 ohms. How much you are going to get? If you simplify, this is coming as 0.625 divided by 1000 plus 102.38, 0.625 divided by answer, I am getting 5.66 into 10 power minus 4. Am I right? So if you simplify this, how much I am going to get? I am going to get 5.6695 into 10 power minus 4. And 566 micro amperes I am getting. Am I right? So roughly I can make 567. Am I right or not? So meter current is coming as 567 microamperes. Am I right or not? Am I right or not? Yes, 567 microamperes I am getting. So now according to the deflection sensitivity problem, according to the deflection sensitivity, he has very clearly given in the question, deflection sensitivity of the meter he has given as how much here? Deflection sensitivity of the question he has given how much here? Deflection sensitivity has given us 0.1 degree per milliampere. 0.1 degree per milliampere, right? Am I right or not? Here, see the question. In the question, he has given sensitivity. Deflection sensitivity of the meter is how much? 0.1 degree per milliampere. So, I can write deflection sensitivity is given as 0.1 degree per 0.1 degree per milliampere. Na? Enti chadama? 0.1 degree per milliampere, right? So, 0.1 degree per milliampere. So, deflection sensitivity is 0.1 degree per milliampere. For 1 milliampere, it is giving 0.1 degree. So, 567 microamperes or 56.7, yes, degree per microampere hona chahiye. Degree per milliamperes na, Sneha? Sneha, degree per milliampere. He has given in milliamperes. He has given in milliamperes na? Yes. So, how much? 56.56 milliamperes. Okay. You take it as microamperes better. You take it as microampere, then it will be easy. Okay. In the question, you click modify. Why? Because the deflection is so small. Okay. It is a very small deflection. I have given a rough number. So you take it as microampere. Yes, very good. Very good, Sneha. So I will take this as microampere. So why? Because some reasonable deflection should come. So for 1 microampere, so for 1 microampere, 0.1 degrees, please convert the units. Yes, that's why I have changed. Sneha, I have changed. 0.1 degree per microampere, okay? Sensitivity have changed, 0.1 degree per microampere. Is it okay now? I have changed the sensitivity as 0.1 degree per microampere. I have modified the question. Just you can follow the units, okay? 0.1 degree per microampere. So, 0.1 degree per microampere, then for 567 microamperes, 567 microamperes, how much? 56.7 degrees. 56.7 degrees. So, when it shows 56.7 degrees, the meter is calibrated as 567 microamperes. All of you understood, my dear students? Ananjabose, how it can be related to instrumentation? How it can be linked to generalized instrumentation? If you check now, this deflection, whatever you are getting, this deflection in the meter is passing directly proportional to current in the meter. Current in the meter is directly proportional to what? Current in the meter, this particular current in the meter is proportional to this VTH and RTH values. This current in the meter is proportional to this VTH and RTH values or not? Current is proportional to VTH value or not? Am I right or not? V Thevenin is nothing but Vs by 4 into del R by R na. That is proportional to delta R or not. So this delta R is proportional to some temperature or some stress, whatever. Real time parameter na Tanjim Kanam, are you there? Real time parameter or not? This can be related to any temperature or stress. This can be related to any humidity. This can be related to some flow rate. This can be related to some flow of a hot wire, flow of a hot gas. Why? Because a hot gas can affect the temperature. This temperature can affect this resistance. And PMMC is indirectly used as an application for measurement of some non-electrical quantities also, na? The more is the temperature in your room, the more is the current, na? The more is the deflection, na? All of you understood, Tanjim Kanam, this is what the application. Sneha, do you understand? Actually, meters, directly they are measuring current, but indirectly they are measuring the temperature. So, I can contribute like this. This 56.7 point degrees corresponds to some 567 microamperes. It may be related to some temperature. I can calibrate this as 56.7 Celsius temperature. Yes or not? That means the meter is nowhere. See, meter can be calibrated like anything, right, Mathur? meter can be calibrated. Meter scale can be calibrated like anything, right, Mathur? So this is the meter. So these are our readings, right? These are our readings, right? So actually current is entering, right? Current is entering, right? So this current is, this is zero, this is our deflection. Deflection degrees, degrees, 1 degree, 10 degree, 20 degree, 30 degree, 40 degree, 50 degree, 60 degree, like this, right? It also can be converted as, it also can be scaled as 1 Celsius, 10 Celsius, 20 Celsius, 30 Celsius, 40 Celsius, 50 Celsius, 60 Celsius, right? It is also can be calibrated as 1 kilometer per hour, 10 kilometers per hour, 20 kilometers per hour, 60 kilometers per hour, right? It also can be calibrated as Pascal, 10 Pascals, 60 Pascals. All of you understood, my dear students? All of you understood, sir? Can be used in strain gauge, temperature sensors, and hot water thermometers. In our bikes, you can see the deflection. Whenever your speed is increasing, the meter is showing the reading like this. You are jumping from 45 kilometers per hour. You have to go fast. So you are moving to 120 kilometers per hour. So this is actually not speed by, when you are rising, that current is changing. The current in the meter is changing. The current in the meter is calibrated as 120 kilometers per hour. This is what we call calibration. What we call this as? This is what we call calibration of meters. Calibration of meters. Tanjeem Kanam, clear? Tanjeem Kanam, clear? Sneha Savant, clear? Chalo, 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 chalo. I hope all of you clear. My dear students, all of you comfortable what I am talking? Everything is clear? Please, all of you show me your thumbs here. Please, all of you show me your thumbs and everything so that we can go for the next level. So we have done good problems on PMMC, right? Clear, my dear students? Please, all of you show me the thumbs here. All of you, 1 second, please show me the thumbs so that I will go for the next session, okay? Chalo, I am removing all these things because I need the slides. Yeah. Chalo. Our next topic is, next instrument is moving iron. So this is our moving iron instrument diagram. Moving iron construction. If you see this moving iron, in moving iron there is a coil. Okay? So please try to understand. In moving iron there is a coil. There is an iron disc. So this is a coil winding, try to understand. So this is a coil winding, this is a coil winding, this is the iron disc. How to understand this? All of you just visualize my hand. All of you visualize my hand. You imagine this as a coil. This as a coil, okay na? A coil is like this. So when you cut this coil, you can see the upper cross section and the bottom cross section. All of you able to see my hands? All of you able to see to my two hands? So this is the upper cross section, this is the lower cross section. Okay na? So whenever the current passes through this particular coil, whenever current passes through this particular coil, what happens? See, whenever a current passes through particular coil, what happens now? It provides certain magnetic field na? It provides some magnetic field or not? Okay, so this provides certain magnetic field, this provides certain magnetic field, it acts like an electromagnet or not. So due to the current, a magnetic field is created or not. So this phenomenon is called as electromagnet. This phenomenon is called as electromagnet. Clear, all of you? It is not permanent magnet. It is not at all permanent magnet. If current is equal to zero, this electromagnetic field also zero. Do you understand? So when this current is equal to zero, this is also going to be zero. It is not a stronger magnetic field like PMMC. In PMMC, we are using a permanent magnet. North pole and south pole, all Nico made magnet we are using. But here we are using a coil The coil, whenever current is passing, the coil itself is having two terminals. One is north pole, other one is the south pole. Clear all of you? So the amount of magnetic field created is purely proportional to the current passing through the meter. Current passing through the meter. When current is more, obviously magnetic flux will be more. When magnetic flux increases, self-inductance also increases. Agree, Tanjeem, Kanam? Other students, all of you agree? We know very well, L is equal to N phi by I. All of you know this formula very well. Self-inductance is equal to number of flux lines per current travel. So L is purely proportional to the magnetic flux or not? L, self-inductance induced is purely proportional to the magnetic flux or not? Yes. Now imagine this is my particular coil. Inside the coil, there is an iron disc. Imagine this particular pen as an iron disc. Or you take this particular calculator as an iron disc. You take this particular calculator as a moving iron disc. So first, whenever there is no current, this iron disc position was like this. See, I cannot show you both hands at a time. I cannot show you both the hands at a time. Try to assume one hand. Okay, na? So this is our structure and this is our iron disc. Now, whenever current passes through here, when there is no current, there is no magnetic field. When there is no current, there is no magnetic following Ananya Bose. When there is no current, there is no magnetic field. Whenever current is passing, there is a magnetic field. This is iron. Definitely this iron will be attracted or not? This iron will be attracted or not? This iron will be attracted or not? Do you understand or not, my dear students? Do you understand or not, my dear students? So this is whenever current, you imagine my hand as a current path and you imagine this jaw as a coil. Whenever the current passes through this, this jaw will behave like a coil, then this iron disc will be attracted. How much attraction? How much attraction? That purely depends upon the magnetic field, flux. That purely depends upon the current. That purely depends upon the current. When the current is there, then definitely what happens? It will be deflected. Why? Because the reluctance is going to be changed. Whenever there is no current, this coil, this iron disc is like this. This iron disc is like this. So there is a lot of air gap. Lot of air gap. Air gap means it offers reluctance, na? You know reluctance? You know reluctance? All of you know reluctance. Reluctance is equal to 1 by mu L by A. 1 by u L by A. So flux and reluctance both are inversely proportional, na? Flux and reluctance both are inversely proportional, na, my dear students. Flux and reluctance both are inversely proportional. When reluctance decreases, flux increases, na? When reluctance decreases, flux increases, then self-inductance attached also increases, na? Do you understand? So when you see the sequence, current passes, magnetic flux established. Change in current, change in magnetic flux. Change in magnetic flux, attraction force increases. When attraction force increases, reluctance decreases. When reluctance decreases, this moving iron will be attracted. When moving iron is attracted, very good. When moving iron is attracted, for this moving iron, attach a pointer. Imagine this black pen as a pointer. Now what happens? This iron disc moves like this. This pointer is moving like this or not? My dear student, Ananya Bose, when iron disc moves like this, see this pointer, this is my pointer. So this pointer attached to this iron disc also moves like this or not? So iron disc is moving like this, pointer is moving like this. So how much deflection is happening here, that is purely depend upon the what? Current, na? Now, most important point here is, if alternating current is applied, will it work or not? Will it work? This mechanism will work for AC also or not? Tanjeem Kanam, please answer. This mechanism will work for AC also, na? Why? Because when normally positive side is traveling, this is acting like a north pole, this is acting like a south pole. Why? Because imagine the coil like this. This is a coil structure. So this is a north pole, this is a south pole. For AC current, what happens now? For positive ripple, this is north pole, this is south pole. For negative current, what happens? This becomes north pole, this becomes south pole. Am I right? North pole, south pole will be changed to south pole, north pole. First positive pole, this is north pole, this is south pole. Next negative pulse of the first cycle, this becomes south pole, this becomes north pole. Attraction force continues or not? Attraction force continues or not? So deflection will continue or not? deflection will continue or not. That means I can use this instrument for measurement of AC also, na? Ananja Bose, I can use this instrument for measurement of AC also, na? Yes. So this is what the mechanism. So this is the cross sectional view. If you see, this is a coil winding and this iron disc. Initially the iron disc is like this. So if you check this position as a theta, okay, na? So theta is 90 degrees, self inductance is very, very less. Now when a current passes here, listen carefully. Whenever a current passes here, see here, there is a current passage through this coil. There is a current passage is happening. There is a current passage is happening through this coil. So whenever a current passes, what happens now? Whenever a current passes here, this particular disc will be attracted. This particular disc will be attracted. If the current increases, still attracted. Like this, the iron disc will be moving like this. When iron disc is moving like this, this pointer will move like this. This pointer will be moving like this. All of you understood, my dear students? It's one of the important instrument which measures AC. Very good. It's one of the important which measures AC. But of course, there is a limitation of frequency. Okay, na? And remember, purely this particular AC current, frequency matters or not? The frequency of this AC current matters or not? The more is the frequency, then there is a limitation for everything, right? There is a limitation. Up to 50 Hz it is okay. But different frequencies will give different deflections or not? Different frequencies will have different deflections or not, my dear students? Yes. This is a frequency dependent instrument. That's only we want, na, Mathur. That's only we want, na. I want this important concept. Why? Because current is equal to, what is this? Current is equal to 2 sine omega t, suppose. A sinusoidal pulse I am taking. Amplitude is 2. This omega is 2 pi f. This omega is 2 pi f. I am taking frequency 1 hertz. And another current I am taking, where is frequency is 2 hertz. Another current I am taking, where frequency is very, very high like this. Amplitudes are same. This frequency is 1 hertz. This frequency is 2 hertz. This frequency is 50 hertz. Then definitely for different frequencies, I can have different deflections or not. Do you agree, my dear students? Do you agree, my dear students? Why? Because the more is the frequency, the more will be the flux affection. Self-inductance and the flux, which are what? The flux is rate of change of flux, na? The rate of change of flux will cause some EMF, na? Do you understand? Now listen, my dear students. See, according to the basic thing, L is equal to self-inductance is equal to N phi by I. I can write like this. Okay, na? So, L into I is equal to N phi. I can write like this. Am I right or not? So, if I take this as L into di by dt plus, why? Because what I want is EMF. We know very well EMF is equal to d phi by dt, na? Rate of change of flux with respect to time, na, my dear students? Rate of change of flux with respect to time. So n phi is equal to L into I. So n into d phi by dt, if you take, that is nothing but EMF, na? So that will become L into di by dt plus I into dl by dt, na? So I can take this as, okay, I can take this as EMF relation. So E is equal to L into di by dt plus I into dl by dt, na? All of you agree? This is the EMF equation. What is energy? We know very well, energy associated, what is the energy formula? Energy associated, what is the formula? Power is equal to energy per time, na? Power is equal to energy per time. P into dt will become energy, na? Am I right or not? But what is this P? Power. Power means E into I, na? Can I write like this, my dear students? So energy associated in a coil, energy associated in an inductor can be taken like this formula, E into I into dt. All of you agree? Power is equal to energy per time. Energy is equal to power into time dt over a derivative time. Power means voltage into current, na? So the energy into I into dt will give me the energy associated. Energy associated. So what is this energy? This energy, this energy associated E into I into dt. So E is equal to L into di by dt now, my dear students, plus I into dl by dt now, my dear students, into I into dt now. Now, if I simplify, let us take this as capital I. Okay, if I simplify, what I am going to get? If you multiply I into L, dt dt gets cancelled. I am going to get di plus this is going to become I square into dl. Sneha Savant, are you following? So energy associated is given by this formula na. Energy given can be taken like this na. Energy given for a coil can be taken like this na. IL di plus I square dl. Yes or no? Yes or no? So let us take this as equation 1. Let us take this as equation 1. Now, second thing, what is the energy of an inductor? Energy stored in an inductor. Can you tell me? Energy stored in an inductor. Energy stored in an inductor. Energy stored in inductor, Sneha Savant, I'm expecting the response. Energy stored in an inductor. Energy stored in inductor. Very good. Half I square L na dhaval maryada. Very good. Half I square L. Very good. So this is half L I square. Half L I square. Okay. So what is the incremental in energy? Increase in energy. Increase in energy for a change in current. For a change in current. How to do it? How to do it? Increase in energy for a change in current, that is nothing but dl by di na. Energy associated by with derivation of with I na. So when you do derivation, what I am going to get? Energy incremented half I square into dl plus l. Yeah, what is energy associated with? What you are going to get? Incremental in energy. Increment energy, how much you are going to get, my dear students? Make it fast. L into I. Increase in energy. That will be 1 by 2 I square dl plus. This will be what? 1 by 2 L into 2 I na. Am I right or not, my dear students? So 2 gets cancelled. So what I am going to get? 1 by 2 I square into dl plus L into L I d I na. Am I right or not? So this is increment in energy. Change in energy. Increment in energy for a change in current. Am I right or not? Agree. Next. So whenever you are giving this much energy, first, whenever energy given will create certain increment in energy in the inductor, that creates certain mechanical work also. Ananja Bose, there is a mechanical work. What is the mechanical work? Mechanical work is nothing but the iron disc is moving na. So the mechanical work done. Mechanical work done by iron disc. Mechanical work done by iron disc is nothing but W. That is nothing but deflection torque into theta na, or deflection torque into d theta, Td into d theta. Agree? So this is what? Your energy given is going to be made modified into these two forms or not? All of you agree, my dear students? All of you agree? So whenever energy supplied to inductor will make incremental energy plus mechanical work done. Na? You understand? So what is the energy supplied to the inductor? That is ILDI plus I square into DL. Na? Next, incremental energy is nothing but half I square DL plus LIDI plus mechanical work done TD into D theta. Na? Yes or not? So now if you simplify what I am going to get, my dear students, if you simplify what I am going to get, this ILDI term gets cancelled. And if you bring this, it will become half I square DL. Half I square DL is equal to TD into D theta. Na? So from this, what is the deflection torque I am going to get? I am going to get half I square DL by D theta. Na? All of you agree, my dear students. This is one of the important understanding you require. Tanjim Kanam, you are asking. Tanjim Kanam, yesterday you were saying that, sir, I am comfortable with initial instruments, but I am not comfortable with other instruments. Remember, my dear students, for every instrument, same story. For every instrument, you can use this formula. You are giving certain energy that makes incremental energy in the inductor. Incremental energy in inductor, and that also causes some mechanical work done. So that is what the law of conservation of energy. What we call this as law of conservation of energy. If you understand this form, this derivation, it will be easy to understand all the instruments. Pranali, Ananja Bose, Shiva Prasad, Sneha, other students, Dhaval, Maryada, Tanjim Kanam, repeating, I am repeating. All of you understood here. See here, what I have done. I am giving an energy. We have taken a self-inductance. Sir, AC power we scope hona chahiye na. Sir, AC power V cos pi hona chahiye. Kya hai, what is that? VI cos pi. Achcha, VI cos pi hona chahiye na. AC power ko VI cos pi hona chahiye. Very good. आपने cos phi नहीं लिया? Yes, I have not taken cos phi. I am taking the unity power factor. Okay na? I am taking the unity power factor because it is made by inductance. Okay na? It is made by inductance, so I am taking the unity power factor. No problem. So I want to get the deflection. So I am taking the EI cos phi. If you take the power associated, means EI cos phi. Cos phi you can take the unity power factor. Ideal inductor I am taking because these are ideal. This derivation is for ideal. Energy associated in an inductor ideally. For ideal inductor, the phi is equal to 0 na? Tanjim Kanam, for ideal inductor, the phi is equal to 0 na? Power factor angle. Followed cos phi, cos 0 is equal to 1. Good. So see here, what I have taken? Self-inductance I have taken, energy associated in an inductor. For a pure inductor, yes, zero power factor. For a pure inductor I am taking. If you want to use for power measurement, we need a separate instrument. We are having a separate instruments like dynamometer. Actually, I will explain that power measurement in detail later. Okay? If you want to go for dynamometer, in that is what doubt. Sir, if I have AC, if you have AC instrument, okay? So this particular dynamometer is just a transfer of these characteristics. Moving iron, whatever is there, we are transferring its characteristics to the dynamometer. That's what we are doing. Okay? Chal. Now, if you check here this formula, energy associated is equal to this. Energy associated is equal to ILDI plus I square DL. Next. Incremental energy is this half I square DL plus LIDI. Next. Mechanical work done is this. All of you agree up to this. TD is equal to half I square DL by dT. All of you agree? Is it clear? Yes or not? Yes, that is also one reason, Tanjim Kanam, that is also one reason the deflection torque cannot be dependent on the power. If you take the power formula as cos phi, deflection torque becomes zero. Do you understand my point? It cannot be used for power measurement. That is the reason, Tanjim. If you use this power relation, what happens? Cos phi, cos 90 is equal to zero, then the deflection torque will be zero. That's why we are going for a separate instrument. That's why we are using the electrodynamometer. Do you agree now? Clear? Very good point, Sneha. Energy kabhi bhi zero nahi hota. Perfect. Clear all of you? Shall I proceed, my dear student? Shall I proceed? You got it? Tanjim, your question is valid. Correct? Sure. So deflection, all of you agree? Deflection torque is equal to half into I square DL by dt, followed or not up to this? I need response. Sneha Savant, I need response. Please proceed. Thank you, Aranjabos. Thank you. See, one thing I want to tell you, you have to remember this concept. Those students who are unable to remember the formulas, they have to remember this concept. The same concept we are using for all instrument. Electrodynamometer, same concept. You are giving some current. Uske pas already some energy is there. In that particular circuit, there is already some energy is there. Aapne a energy ko change kar rahe. Aapne current de rahe or voltage, current you are giving na. All the instruments, all the electrical measuring instruments are measuring current. Whether it is a PMMC, basically current. All electrical instruments are going to give the deflection because of the current. Keep that in mind. All electrical instruments like PMMC, moving iron, dynamometer, fundamental thing is current, na? Deflection comes to the current. Are yaar, first question mein kuch current diya. And first mein kuch ne kuch energy diya. Next, what happened? Whenever you are changing this current, there is a change in energy. First, you are given some current. Because of the current and because of the voltage, there is energy associated initially. Now you are changing this current. Whenever you are changing this current, there is a change in energy here. There is a change in energy associated, increment in energy, change for the increment energy. That incremental energy also results in mechanical work done. So keep this in mind. Energy supplied to the inductor will cause what? Increment energy plus mechanical work done. If you remember this formula, dynamometer, clear. energy meter clear, power factor meter clear, all megger clear, all instruments understanding can be clear. Dhaval, all instruments understanding will be clear. Okay na? Chalo. So this is the deflection torque. So we know deflection torque is equal to half I square dl by d theta. Must and should this dl by d theta units must be Henry per radian. Henry per radian. Remember this point. Why? Because this is a radial distance. MI is ammeter, it cannot measure power, we have to use dynamo. Yes, that's how I have given. So, Henry per radian, clear na? Remember this point, there is a confusion, my dear students. dl by d theta must be always in Henry per radian. Why? Because the deflection which is happening is very, very small deflection. Okay, now we are calibrating in terms of degrees, but this has to be taken Henry per radian. And what is the controlling torque? We know there is a spring is there here in the construction. In the construction, there is a spring na? In the construction, if you check, there is a spring, so there is a control weight. So I will explain this control mechanism later. Let me continue to the derivation. So TC is equal to KT, that is a basic expression we know. TC is equal to K theta, that is a basic expression we know. So at equilibrium, what happens? TD is equal to TC. So half I square, Sneha, clear? Half I square. Change in inductance for a deflection theta is equal to K into theta. So what is our actual deflection? This is the theta. So theta is equal to half I square by 2K into dl by d theta. Try to understand, my dear students, here. So this one I square into 1 by 2K change in inductance for a particular theta, if you take this as constant, for a unit current, this deflection will be current. This, see, for a current of a frequency, try to understand my words clearly. Ananja Bose, Dhaval, Sneha, try to understand my words clearly. For a value of current of a frequency, this dl by d theta remains constant, na? If frequency changes, obviously this changes. But frequency is constant, suppose, then dl by d theta is constant. Then theta is proportional to what? Theta is proportional to I square, now, my dear student. That means the scale you are going to get in the form of what? Linear or non-linear? You are going to get in the form of parabola, na? You are getting like in the form of parabola or not? That means initially the readings here are crowded. So this is the current and this is the theta. In the middle they are somewhat linear, and at the final they are very spacious. At the final the graph is very, very spacious like this. So here we are getting crowded deflection. Here we are getting middle linear, and here we are getting spacious. Why? Because theta is proportional to I square. For example, if you take I is equal to 0.05 milliamperes, then theta is how much? 0.05 square. If you take 0.06 milliamperes, then theta will be how much? 0.06 square. So these two values are very, very close. If these two values are very, very close, that's why initial, for shorter values of current, for small i's, theta is crowded. This crowded is also called cramped. Suppose if I is going to somewhat middle, somewhere suppose is going very, 0.5, 0.5, 0.7, 0.6, then it will be somewhat linear. If current is going very, very high, suppose if current is going 5, then theta is proportional to I square. That means theta will become 25. If current is going to 6, this I is equal to 6, then theta will become 36. So there is a lot of space. That means for higher I's, theta is spacious. That's why the scale is non-uniform. You should not say non-linear. Wrong answer. If you write non-linear, it is wrong answer. You write non-uniform, then it is right in my respective. You should not say non-linear. Very good, Dhaval. Very good. Crowded linear space. Tech Madhurji, non-linear scale is wrong. Tech Madhurji, that I am telling. Non-linear scale is wrong. You must mention non-uniform scale. It is non-uniform, not non-linear. Not non-linear. It is linear in the middle. Tech Mathur. It is linear in the middle. Linear for mid-range. All of you agree, my dear students? Dear students followed. Dear students enjoyed. Tech Mathurji, your doubt is clear. It is non-uniform. That's a very, very important question. Many times in the IES, this question was asked. Crowded plus linear plus spacious. Linear is there, na? How can you say non-linear? How can you say non-linear? That's why cramping effect. Very good, Pranali. Chalo. Linear is there. And one of the important thing is you are measuring the I square. You are measuring the I square. That means you are measuring what? You can measure both AC as well as? Or an R, yaar. As a whole, it is non-linear means what? Suppose, my dear student Mathur, suppose MI instrument can work for a range of, suppose 0.5 amperes to some 10 amperes. Okay, this is the range. So, suppose I have given 0.5 ampere to 1 ampere. In this range, it is crowded. But if my application demands, how can we trace input frequency variation using the MI meter? How can we trace the input frequency variation using MI meter? No. Frequency variations are very, very tough to remember. Frequency variations we cannot do with this meters, moving iron meters, very, very tough. Okay. So that's why we are having separate instruments called dynamometers. Frequency error is there, Ananja Bose. Ananja Bose, frequency errors will be there. Frequency error. Moving iron instrument is possessing frequency error. Same current changed to different frequency, then the different reading will come. That is an error. That is an error, Ananja Bose. Okay, na? If you want to eliminate that frequency errors, we have to do some compensation mechanisms. Errors is a separate story. We'll discuss that later. Okay? So, this is crowded. But Mathur, from 1 ampere to 5 amperes, 1 ampere to 5 amperes, it is linear. If your application is this, then the instrument is linear here. If the application is 1 ampere to 5 amperes, the instrument is linear. If your application is 0.5 to 1 ampere, this is crowded. If your application is above 5 amperes to 10 amperes, then I can say non-linear. Do you understand, Mathur? Wide range. Minimum range, it is crowded. If it is 1 ampere to 5 amperes, it is linear. Okay, clear, my dear students? All of you understood? Now, all of you agree it is suitable for both AC and DC. Why? Because theta is proportional to I square. Suppose if you write TC in V square also we can write I by R. Why? Because that particular coil can have certain resistance, I square, V square. Clear, Ananja? Sir, now linear only to some range. Yes, linear only to some range. Yes, if your instrument demands that, see my lab mein, mera experiment mein, Mathurji, mera experiment mein, mera requirement, itna hi range hai. My requirement itna hi range hai. Suppose my requirement is 1 ampere to 5. I have a application of 1 ampere to 5 ampere AC current measurement. I need a linear instrument, which you will choose. I have an application of 1 ampere to 5 ampere AC current measurement. Which instrument you will use? I want a linear current measurement, linearity and other things are defined over a range. Try to understand Pranali, Tech Mathur. Every instrument over a range, it is linear. But PMMC is having linearity over a wide range. Very good. Chalo. Clear? Now let us go for a problem, beta. Enough ho gaya. Ek problem karenge. Fatafat. Problem gives you the better understanding. Kidhar gaya rahe problem? Yes. Please try to do this question. Fast. First, the inductance of a certain moving iron ammeter is given as this, picohenry. So he has given L as how much? 8 plus 4 theta minus half theta square picohenry. PH means picohenry, beta. Picohenry. Anindya, do. Where theta is the deflection in radian from zero position. The control spring torque is 12 into 10 power minus 6 newton meter per radian. So control spring torque means TC. TC is given as 12 into 10 power minus 6 newton meter per radian. Calculate the scale position in radian for current 1 ampere, 2 ampere, 3 ampere, 5 ampere. You please do for 1 ampere, enough. So, he is asking the deflection theta. Try to do it. For a current reading of 1 ampere, let us do one thing, okay? He has given many values, you take one value, okay? Sneha, you take only one value is enough. Chalo, fast. Jaldi khatam karenge, time is running here, other faculty is waiting, other session is waiting, beta. 9:30 को और एक सेशन है ग्लोबल चैनल पर. हम जल्दी से जल्दी ये चैनल को उसको वेकेट करना है मेरे दोस्तों. सो प्लीज ट्राई टू डू दिस प्रॉब्लम फास्टली. सेल्फ इंडक्टेंस इज गिवन, कंट्रोलिंग टॉर्क इज गिवन. सो क्वेश्चन आस्क्ड इज फॉर ए करंट ऑफ 1 एम्पियर थीटा इज डैश. कर सकते ना, आराम से कर सकते ना. डिफ्लेक्शन टॉर्क इज इक्वल टू कंट्रोलिंग टॉर्क. डिफ्लेक्शन टॉर्क इज इक्वल टू हाफ आई स्क्वायर dl by d theta, that is should be equal to k theta. So k theta ka value already diya hai, deflection controlling torque ka value already diya hai, 12 into 10 power minus 6 newton meter per radian, that is given. Now what I want is, I want the dl by d theta. So first of all, l is given. So this l is given. So from this you can find out the dl by d theta, na my dear students. So what is the dl by d theta? Derivative of 8, 0. Derivative of 4 theta, 4 minus. Derivative of this, 2 theta. 4 minus 2 theta, dl by d theta na? Sorry. Bas. 4 minus 2 theta na? So, dl by d theta ka value kitna aya mujhe? 4 minus 2 theta aya. So, if you substitute that here, half I square, what is this? 4 minus 2 theta. For a current of 1 ampere, if I is equal to 1 ampere, then this will become half into 1 into 4 minus 2 theta into 12 into 10 power minus 6 newton meter per radian. Please simplify and tell me theta in radians. How much are you? Tech Mathur ji says 3.99. Other students, 4 minus 2 theta is equal to 6. 0.00, 4 into 10 power minus 6. 4 minus 2 theta is equal to 4 minus 2 theta is equal to 24 into 10 power minus 6. Kitna aa raha hai beta? Please tell me yaar, how much you are getting? How much are getting, my dear students? Anandja Bose, 3.99. Very good. 3. Simple, na? See, in electrical measurements, If you remember the formulas, you can easily answer the question. Yes, 4 minus theta. 4 minus 2 theta. I'm sorry. This is 2 theta. 2 theta squared, 2 theta gets cancelled. Correct. 4 minus. Correct. Perfect. कर सकते यू आर डूइंग द जॉब ना यू कैन डू बट ईएससी इज ए तपस निकेश नितीश पटेल ईएससी इज ए तपस ईएस इंजीनियरिंग सर्विस एग्जामिनेशन यू शुड प्रिपेयर लाइक ए योगी देन ओनली यू कैन गेट इट ओके ना सो यू हैव टू डेडिकेट योर टाइम बट यू आर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर Can you please explain one more time about increase in energy and work done in a coil? Yeah, listen. See, there is a system, whether it is a moving iron system. For this moving iron, whenever you are giving some current already some energy is there in it, clear? Whenever you are giving some current, energy is associated in the inductor already. Now whenever this current is changing as di, this energy is resulted as incremental in energy. Plus, as there is a pointer mechanism is also involved, so that is a mechanical work done. Okay, so energy supplied is changing. Whenever you are changing this current, energy supplied is changing. Whenever energy supplied, there is an incremental in energy, and that incremental energy also provides what? A mechanical work done. Your total energy is distributed into two forms, my dear student. See here, what I have done. First initially, energy associated I have taken. Power is equal to energy per time. Energy is equal to power into time. Over a period of time, energy is equal to EIT. Over a period of time, energy is equal to EIT. Okay, na clear, dear students? Nikhil, I am giving the current over a period of time. So, energy is EIT. EIDT. So, I am giving current because of the current and there is a EMF. So, over a period of time, energy supplied is this much. Energy supplied for an inductor is this much. Already before certain time, inductor mein thoda energy rehta na? Inductor mein already some energy hota na? Energy stored in inductor already is how much? Half Li square. Whenever this current is changing, definitely energy associated also going to be changed. Whenever this current is changing, energy incremented in the inductor or not? So, energy stored is this. Incremental energy, what happens now? Incremental energy for a change in current will be dEl by dI. So, derivative with respect to I kare to kya hoga? So, this is half I square dL. So, there is an incremental portion. Every part is going to be incremented. So, this is 2dI for an infinitesimal increment. So, incremental energy for a change in current is this. Everything gets incremented. But this also gives one mechanical work done. Whenever you are supplying, the supplying energy, what is doing? Because of the supplying energy, the energy associated is changing. we are considering energized inductor initially. Yes, initially it is having some energy. Now I am changing the connector. Yes. We have to start from t is equal, we have to start from t is equal to 0 plus. Whenever for a change in current, there is a change in energy. Okay, now my dear student. For a change in current, there is a change in energy. Over a time, I am telling. Over a time, see here. Over a dt, we have taken, see here. Over a dt, we have taken here. Over a time. Yes or not? Integration over a time. Over a time. That means initially it is having some energy, we are assuming, and then there is an incremental energy. Why? Because t is equal to 0, it's time taking phenomenon. T is equal to 0, t is equal to 0 plus, t is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So just at t is equal to 0 plus half I square L. Just at t is equal to 0 plus half I square L. Over a time. Energy is integration of power I and t na. Yes or not? Integral time. All of you clear now? Clear now? Yes sir, get this concept best. Thank you my dear students. I have to close this session. So please remember this concept. Please remember this concept. It will be useful everyone. I hope all of you enjoyed my session. Tanjim, your doubts clarified. Tech Mathuri, your doubts clarified. Sneha Savant, your doubts clarified. Thank you very much. Sir, your best teacher of measurement. Thank you, love you all. Tech Mathur, thank you very much. Thank you very much. I want to update, I want to give the best every day. I will explore myself in all the concepts. I will explore myself in all the concepts. Okay, na? So I want to explore in all dimensions of my concepts. My conceptual understanding, I want to establish more. So that's why I prefer the teaching. In teaching only, I can improve day by day. In everyday teaching will give me everyday improvement. Okay, na? So teaching is a profession where there is a lot of scope for improvement personally and subject point of view and also other points of view. Okay, na? So that's why I love the profession, and for my profession I'm doing my best. Okay, my dear students. So enjoy for today. So next class will come with some more problems of moving iron, especially errors in instruments. Up to now we have discussed PMMC moving iron. Now we'll discuss comparative errors. Sir, in ISRO same syllabus as ESCR, almost same syllabus, same syllabus. Hats off to you, sir. Thank you, Bose. You are my instrumentation student. Anandya Bose, you are my instrumentation student. You know the struggle of instrumentation people. First time, itna acha details hai pada, sir, only because of you. Thanks a lot. Thank you very much, Tanjim. Thank you very much. You all, you ask some beautiful doubts, Tanjim. You ask some good doubts. Your doubts are always good. Your doubts are always conceptual. Very good doubts. Thank you, sir. Chalo. Tata. Bye-bye. Take care. We'll meet tomorrow. Love you all. Love you, Gate Academy 2.0. Thank you. Other faculties waiting. Chalo.